What we're finding is artificial intelligence is affecting our lives in very meaningful ways, just at an amazing trajectory and pace. You can imagine all of the ways that AI is just sort of proliferating in our lives. For example, autonomous cars run very sophisticated artificial intelligence, and they need to do these processes with high performance because you don't want to get them wrong, and they need to do them quickly. Now, the way that a lot of these applications are handled today is the data is sensed by some device and then sent to the cloud, where you can do artificial intelligence on heavy-duty computers. But that movement to the cloud poses a security concern, it poses a latency concern, and you may not even have connectivity. You know, there's real technological bottlenecks that need to be solved. So that's driving us towards something called edge AI, where you're actually moving the artificial intelligence computations close to the source of the data. Essentially, what the architecture does is, in a computer chip, we have a lot of data that we need to crunch, and that's stored in memory. Instead of moving that data out of the memory to do the number crunching, this technology does that number crunching on that data right there in memory. And in doing that, it eliminates the costs of moving that data out of memory, the energy costs, the time costs, and so on. And so that's essentially at the heart of it, what this technology is trying to do. So being able to keep that computing locally really enables artificial intelligence to spread its wings in ways that it couldn't before.